You are watching the Expected Score channel. In this video, we will explain how to use XG statistics to predict the probabilities of the match with the Monte Carlo simulator. And at the end of this video, you will know how to get the file with the Monte Carlo simulator for free. There are many ways to use XG for value bets searching. You can analyze football matches manually, use XG with our XG manager, or create your betting software with our API. And you can use the Monte Carlo simulator to calculate the probabilities of a match with the XG stats. We will review the example of the Monte Carlo simulator developed by the owners of the Expected Score project. But first, let's clarify what the Monte Carlo method is. So, Monte Carlo is a method for solving math problems. It is based on a modeling of multiply probability simulations. In football, the Monte Carlo simulator is a tool that converts XG in probabilities of the outcomes of a match. It works the following way. We develop the model of a football match and generate the football match using the XG statistics. But one match is not enough. The results of a game are random, the same as in real life. The results of one match between the teams are always random. That is why we should generate not one match, but the whole chain of the matches. A large number of matches allow us to calculate the probabilities of one or another outcome in a match. Moreover, with Monte Carlo, we can calculate not only the outcomes, we can also get additional data. For example, we can calculate how often the team will win when the match is drawn on the 18th minute and others. This Monte Carlo simulator includes 100,000 matches, according to which we calculate the probabilities. We have created this version specially for the video. In our work, we use this simulator that consists of 300,000 matches and calculates much more probabilities. For example, it can calculate the probability to win a half. So the results of this version can be less accurate than our extended version of the simulator, because this sample is not enough. Yes, the example of 100,000 matches is still not enough. And now imagine the people who make their conclusions on the results of only one match. Let's get to work. Our simulator includes two different tabs. The first one is results. Here we insert the data and their output the results of the generations. The second tab, simulator, is the simulator itself. It includes 100,000 matches. Here the simulator processes data and calculates the probabilities that we can see in the output spreadsheets. What kind of shots should we insert in this simulator? Open the results tab. Here you can see the shots spreadsheet, which includes the cells to input the data. What kind of data? We insert the XG values of each shot in the match, both for the home and away teams. We can insert for each of them up to 40 shots. Open the match on the Expected Score website. For example, the 17th days of League 1, Lille and Troyes. Open the match review tab. Copy all the shots from the match with the XG values and input them into the shot spreadsheet. Now let's have a look at the results of the generations. So if the teams made nearly the same shots in each game on a long distance, Lille wins 67% of the matches. 27% of games end up in a draw, and only 6% of the games win draw. Remember that each shot in the match influences the probabilities and changes them. Most people do not pay attention to the shots which have not ended in the goal, or the shots seems to be not dangerous. But each shot in a match matters and changes the probabilities of the outcomes of a match. When you realize this, you will start to look at the football matches differently, not as a spectator, but as analyst. Repeat one more time. With this set of shots, Lille wins 67% of matches. 27% of games end up in a draw, and only 6% of games end up in a win. let's add Trois one dangerous moment. For example, imagine that besides all the dangerous moments that the teams have, Trois have made an additional dangerous moment from a pretty good position with 30% probability on a goal, shot with 0.3 xG. Insert this shot in a Trois cell. As you can see, the probabilities to win a match have changed. Trois probability of winning this match has risen more than twice. Only one dangerous moment essentially has modified the probabilities of match outcomes. Most people watching the game will never pay attention to this shot. They will notice it only in goals. Most people are interested only in the final score of a match. This match ended with a score of 2-1. Here we can see the luck of both teams. The luck of a home team, who has created dangerous moments only for one goal, but scored two. And the luck of the away team, who haven't created moments even for a goal, but scored one goal. Let's remove this additional dangerous moment and review the probabilities again. We can see the same probabilities. With this set of shots, the home team will win in 67% of games. The probability of a draw is 27%. The probability of Trois winning the game has fallen to almost 6%. With this set of shots, the match will end up in 0-0 score in 18% of games. The probability of 1-1 score is only 8%. And the probability of total under 2.5 is 83%. I remind you that this match has ended in a 2-1 score, and the probability of this score is only 5%. Only 5% of games will end up with the same score. When we add the dangerous moment to the away team, this probability becomes a bit higher, almost 10%, but it's still low. You don't need to focus on the final score of a match. It means nothing because football is a low resultative kind of sport with a high variance. This match, for example, will end up in a 3-1 score only in 3% of games. We can see the same chance for 1-2 score. But these two scores are completely different, so the final score of the match doesn't matter. What is the purpose of using Monte Carlo simulators? It helps to check the profitability of betting models. Players who bet not according to their models, who use manual analysis for bets searching, can check the profitability of their bets on a long distance. The player should start a file with the history of all his bets and insert each bet. Then he should calculate the ROI of each bet using the Monte Carlo simulator and insert the ROI in the file. Also, you will see how you got the positive expected value on a long distance or not. Remember, the results in football are often exposed to variance, which exposes your betting results. Making bets, don't aim at the result. Aim for a positive ROI. So it must be your everyday rule. You make a bet, calculate its ROI according to the XG numbers, and insert ROI in your spreadsheet. In this way, you will clear do you have a positive ROI or not. How to calculate ROI for a bet? To get an ROI, just insert the odds for the market of your bet. For example, you've made a bet on total under 2.5 with the odds 1.6. Insert the odd in the proper cell. As you can see, the ROI for this bet is 19%. You can insert this result in your file. This version of the Monte Carlo simulator calculates probabilities of the played matches. You can calculate probabilities and ROI for the matches that have ended. If you want to use this simulator to calculate the probabilities of football matches, write to our manager in Telegram Messenger and you will get the file for free. You will find the link in the description below the video. Also, we have a Monte Carlo simulator for the upcoming matches. That version of the simulator allows the calculations of probabilities of future matches. It consists of the other formulas but still works, of course, on the XG stats. In one of the next videos, we will discuss this simulator. Subscribe to our channel not to miss our new videos. Visit our website expectedscore.com to get more information about professional sports betting.